Congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez slamming President Trump's efforts to privatize parts of the VA, saying the scandal-plagued Veterans Affairs Department is not broken and arguing that it should be protected.
They're trying to fix the VA for pharmaceutical companies. They're trying to fix the VA for insurance corporations. And ultimately, they're trying to fix the VA for a for-profit healthcare industry that does not put people or veterans first.
Joining us now, Dan Caldwell, Executive Director of Concerned Veterans for America. Dan, good morning to you. And for those who couldn't really make out what she said that the VA is not broken. It offers some of the highest quality care out there. She quoted her parents saying, if it ain't broken, don't fix it. To her, you say what?
First of all, I think she's really off base. There's nobody, first of all, trying to privatize the VA. This is a straw man argument that people who oppose common sense VA reforms like giving veterans more choice use to distract away from real problems at the VA. In many cases, yes, the VA is performing well. It is giving veterans high quality care. But in other cases, they aren't. And just because some veterans are getting good care is an excuse not to fix the VA for the veterans who aren't getting good care. And that's why we support giving veterans choice. So if a veteran wants to access care in the community because he or she feels they aren't getting good care in the VA, they can do that. And that's what President Trump supports, not privatizing the VA, not dismantling the VA. And it's really unfortunate to hear the Congresswoman and others that oppose VA reform use these disingenuous arguments against really popular and common sense reforms.
She made the claim that they're trying to fix the VA for the pharmaceutical companies, for the insurance corporations, and ultimately for a for-profit healthcare industry that doesn't put veterans first. So what is she not understanding here, Dan?
Well, I just think that that is really missing ultimately what the Trump administration is trying to do. Through legislation like the VA Mission Act, they're trying to put the veteran at the center of the VA, not the bureaucracy. And at the end of the day, giving veterans choice will force the private sector and the VA to compete for veterans. This will give veterans the power to choose. And in many cases, some companies, some major insurance companies or major healthcare companies wouldn't like that. They'd rather just get a contract through the VA and force veterans to go to them, or others would like to force veterans to go to the VA. Giving veterans choice gives them power and ultimately forces the private sector and the VA to improve.
So how is the Mission Act going? How are the efforts to reform the VA? How are things going, Dan?
Well, I think that this administration, I think that President Trump deserves a lot of credit, and the Congress and the VA secretary deserve a lot of credit for getting a lot of legislation passed that, if implemented properly, will fix a lot of long-term systemic problems within the VA. The VA Mission Act is an important piece of legislation, and currently the administration is in the process of implementing it. And hopefully on June 6th, we'll have a new VA community care program launched, which will give veterans more choice and more control over their health care. However, you're seeing more people like Congresswoman Ocasio-Cortez in Congress and outside trying to stop that bill and stop the implementation of it and keep veterans trapped in many cases, failing VA hospitals. And that's not just wrong, that's immoral. But I'm confident on June 6th we'll have a good program launched, and that's what we're looking to do, and that's what we'll be paying attention
to at Concerned
Veterans for America.
We've seen a lot of change in leadership there with Robert Wilkie, the current VA secretary, the fourth in the past 4 years. The budget and the employment vacancies, these are some of the problems that it still faces. The number, 42,790 employment vacancies. You're looking at a budget that has doubled in the past decade. It's now over $200 billion. What update can you give us there? Wilkie has since said that they're making groundbreaking progress there on accountability, transparency, and efficiency. Dan.
Well, I do think they've made progress. I do still think there's a lot of work to do, and I think Secretary Wilkie is doing overall a good job. I'll just say on the employment vacancies is that a lot of people cite those numbers as a problem with the VA, and it's really misleading. At the end of the day, even with those vacancies over the past 5 years, the VA has added over 50,000 employees, and they have a lot of those vacancies because the VA and Congress keep creating jobs that they either don't need or can't fill. For example, the Washington, D.C. VA. I talked to the former director a few months ago, and he said on paper he had about 500 vacancies, but when he dug down and looked at them, he really only needed about 5 to 10 of those jobs. So those numbers they throw out are really misleading, and at the end of the day, the VA has gotten a tremendous amount of money from Congress. They've gotten a tremendous number of staff. The VA is actually now bigger than the active duty Navy. So this isn't a resource issue. It's a structural issue. It's a policy issue. And at the end of the day, it's an issue of whether or not we're going to give veterans more control over their health care and allow them to choose.
I think we can all agree on one thing. We want the best possible care for our veterans, and we want to put them first. Dan Caldwell, we appreciate you coming on this morning. Thank you.